He may not have been able to bend all of the elements, but where would Team Avatar be without everyone's favorite Sky Bison? Let's face it, Avatar The Last Airbender would have been a lot shorter if our heroes didn't have Appa to bail them out. So let's take some time to celebrate our favorite flying undulate, from where he traveled to what kind of creature he almost was. Sometimes heroes just need a trusty sidekick to get the job done. Captain America has Bucky Barnes, Doctor Strange has Wong, and Batman has so many Robins. As for Avatar Aang, he has a flying bison named Appa. And just like Aang, Appa is a relic from a different time. We all know about the sad fate of the air nomads, but before the Fire Nation attacked, one of the benefits of being a part of their tribe was getting to choose a sky bison as a lifelong companion. After Aang was revealed to be the Avatar, he and some of the other boys were brought to the Eastern Air Temple to select an air bison. Now, this is a two-way process, in that the bison has to be okay with this arrangement too. It's kind of a wand choosing the wizard scenario if you think about it. Aang and Appa paired up together, and Appa couldn't really have chosen a more difficult kid to form a lifelong connection with considering how the next few years went. As we all know, being able to bend all of the elements is undeniably awesome, but it's also a lot of pressure. When Aang grew overwhelmed, he took off on Appa and ran away from his responsibilities right into a storm. It wasn't the best move, and Aang ended up having to enter his avatar state, freezing both himself and Appa in ice for 100 years. Eventually, Southern Water Tribe siblings Katara and Sokka discovered them and released them from their freezing cold prison. It's hard to know whether being frozen for 100 years caused Appa to question his friendship with Aang, but if it did, he never let it show. Now that's a trusty sidekick. Not only did Appa have to cart Aang around through skies and storms, but now his burden was increased by adding Sokka and Katara to the mix. But as Avatar The Last Airbender fans know, Appa is far more than just a mere mount. He has a playful personality and soon became a best friend to the members of Team Avatar. Appa accompanied Aang on his quest to bend the elements, drive back the Fire Nation, and restore harmony to the land, which are some hefty goals for a bison, even a flying one. Although most of his adventures were with Team Avatar by his side, Appa did manage to become lost at one point while traveling through the Earth Kingdom. Well, less lost and more captured by Sandbenders. His friends, Aang, Katara, Sokka, and Momo, would have helped if they weren't trapped in Washi Tong's library at the time. One of the downsides of Appa is that his size generally means he's forced to wait outside, as most homes and businesses aren't exactly bison friendly. Unfortunately, Appa's side quest with the Sandbenders went about as poorly as possible. They sold him to beetle-headed merchants, and I'm not just being snide because of their sidekick stealing policies. That's what they're called. And from there, poor Appa was sold again to a Fire Nation circus. A trainer tried to make him a star attraction, but Appa, well, he had other ideas. He would rather hang out with a kid who froze him in ice for 100 years than have anything to do with the circus, and eventually escaped back to the Siwong Desert to hopefully reunite with Aang. Unfortunately for Appa, it took some searching to track down Team Avatar, so he was forced to travel through the Earth Kingdom. He ran into the Kyoshi Warriors, who helped him get back into flying shape, which was good timing, since Azula and her allies attacked. Although Appa was able to escape, he was separated from his allies and once more on his own. Next, Appa ran into Guru Patik at the Eastern Air Temple, which was a lucky pit stop. Guru Patik tracked down Aang's energy, but during Appa's journey to Ba Sing Se, he was captured by Long Fang and held in a secret location under Lake Laogai. After being repeatedly captured, poor Appa wasn't even rescued by his friend Aang. Instead, he was discovered by Zuko, who didn't exactly have Appa's best interests at heart at the time. Zuko's plan was to use Appa to pursue Aang, but after some sage advice from his trusty Uncle Iroh, Zuko agreed to let Appa fly free once more. Finally, Appa managed to find his friends where they were facing down Long Fang and the Dai Li. This fantastic flying bison saved the day by chomping on Long Fang and helping Team Avatar secure their factory. He also helped them bust into the royal palace of Ba Sing Se, and his bite mark on Long Fang helped to provide proof of his perfidy to the Earth King. Later, Appa also helped to transport the king, Team Avatar, and even Bosco to safety. Sure, he was down a saddle, but his friends managed to get him a brand new one. He was disguised as an inconspicuous cloud for the invasion of the Fire Nation on the Day of Black Sun, and then took Team Avatar to the Western Air Temple for safety. Or at least that was the plan, because what do you know, Zuko was there, much to the dismay of Team Avatar. But Appa recognized Zuko, and greeted him rather enthusiastically. It wasn't enough to convince the team that Zuko was trustworthy, but it certainly didn't hurt. Once Team Avatar allowed Zuko to teach Aang firebending, it was time for the 100-year war to come to an end. Although Avatar Aang and his human friends got the bulk of the credit, where would they have been without their faithful flying bison Appa? And his journey did not end when the war did either. Team Avatar enjoyed a ride on Appa to celebrate the Harmony Restoration Movement, which was basically a campaign to send Fire Nation colonials back to the Fire Nation. As you can imagine, this led to a bit of a conflict between Fire Lord Zuko and the Earth King at one point, but Appa's not overly involved in human politics, so he let Aang mediate and then helped transport the colonials back to the Fire Nation in the graphic novel The Promise Part 1. Yes, much like our other favorite characters, Appa's adventures continued in the comics. He also took part in The Search, which was about Zuko's search for his long-lost mother, Ursa. Although Appa's always happy to help out, he was less than pleased when he realized Azula would be part of the search party. He helped his team fight against a wolf spirit, and remained a faithful companion and the best-known flying bison around. In fact, most people assume that he was the only flying bison left after the elimination of the air nomads. While this was a reasonable assumption, it was also an incorrect one. In The Legend of Korra, we learned that some air bison had survived and were alive and well on an island in the Fire Nation, living alongside the Bonte tribe. So while Appa may have been the most famous sky bison, he wasn't the last. Appa was capable of airbending, but mostly used his talent to fly or pull off defensive maneuvers. So if you think about it, Avatar Aang wasn't really the last airbender at all. He was just the last human airbender. But let's not split flying bison hairs over it. Although he could fight when necessary, Appa was more of a peaceful creature who could understand the human language even if he couldn't quite replicate it. Appa was strong and sturdy, and carried Team Avatar across the land, seas, and skies. But this legendary flying bison almost looked completely different than the creature we all know and love today. In fact, he very nearly wasn't a bison at all. When Avatar, The Last Airbender creators Bryan Konietzko and Michael Dante DiMartino put together their cast of human characters, they also came up with some imaginary creatures to fill their fictional world with. Aang was going to be over 1,000 years old, and Momo was going to be a robot instead of a lemur. Yeah, go ahead and sit with that mental image for a moment. In addition to a robot, Aang would also be accompanied by a bear dog, while it was some kind of giant hulking animal hybrid that eventually became the inspiration for Avatar Korra's polar bear dog, Naga. But as for Aang, Konietzko and DiMartino had other ideas. They decided that since Aang was originally a farmer kid, it would make sense for him to associate with livestock, and they added a fantasy element by having the animals float. Originally, Aang was going to get a whole herd of these creatures which looked like huge manatees, but in the interest of their animation budget, they decided to give Aang a single flying bison. Appa was also going to have spiral horns, but again, this was deemed too much to constantly animate, so the character design was tweaked. This flying bison also bears a resemblance to another magical mode of transportation that could look familiar to some anime fans. In the classic Hayao Miyazaki film, My Neighbor Totoro, there are plenty of fantastical, soft-looking creatures for sisters Satsuki and Mei to encounter.
And whether you're a human or a Totoro,
sometimes you need a lift, and Uber just isn't available for whatever reason.
Enter the Cat Bus, which is, well, you can probably guess.
Like Appa, the Cat Bus is a multifunctional magical creature who's incredibly furry, almost square-shaped, and has a couple of extra appendages just for fun.
I know, M. Night Shyamalan's The Last Airbender live-action movie isn't the best, to put it mildly,
but there was an interesting thought process behind animating Appa. You'd probably think that the special effects team would have spent a lot of time observing bison, but that wasn't enough to animate Appa's movements, because as you probably noticed, his legs are pretty different in terms of shape, size, and quantity. Since there aren't many six-legged animals around, the team chose to look at elephants and the way they move. So the live-action version of Appa moves a lot more like an elephant would than a bison.
Appa isn't much of a talker, but there is still a voice actor behind all of those sounds he makes, and you might be surprised by some of the entries on his resume. He's voiced by Dee Bradley Baker, who also does the voice for Momo and creatures from The Legend of Korra, including Naga and Pabu. Baker also voices the fish, Klaus Heisler on American Dad, although that particular animal is more than capable of speaking. According to Baker, he was sent pictures of Momo and Appa and had to use his imagination thinking of what they might sound like. Usually, a voice actor records dialogue first and then comes the animation process. But in Appa's case, Baker would watch his animation before chiming in with his sky bison noises. Where do you think Appa ranks amongst the animal hybrids of Avatar The Last Airbender? Discuss how you think he compares to other creatures like lion turtles, tiger monkeys, or zebra seals in the comments section. Don't forget to stay up to date with us here at Screen Rant by clicking on the subscribe button and turning on your notifications for more new videos. Catch you next time.